Talk to me, Kim. I'm looking for a good myth. Got to get something good. What do we got?
All right, let's take a look. Okay, this is a good one.
Okay.
We have a scientist who is trying to analyze basic peptides, mm-hmm. and they're having a hard time getting good peak shape for the basic peptides on the mass spec.
Okay.
So they're using TFA because that helps get them good peak shape.
Yeah.
But it really suppresses their signal. So they want to know if it's possible to use something else and get good peak shape.
That's a great question. I mean, typically scientists will use formic acid.
Yep.
Because they want to get away from using these ion pairing reagents like TFA, mm-hmm. because the TFA competes in the source and suppresses the signal
right.
and creates all sorts of problems. Fortunately, formic acid isn't really a good ion pairing reagent, mm-hmm. and then you get very, very poor peak shape. Mm-hmm. So we're going to have to take a look at this a little bit, maybe look at stationary phase design, and really think about how best to test this on which columns.
I think we've got some work to do.
I think so too. Typically with these pure stationary phases that are being designed and developed today, there is a net zero surface charge on the surface, which allows the basic analytes to almost adsorb to the surface. And you get this really kind of overloaded type of peak shape. So here's an example of what I'm talking about. Here is a loading study where we look at a neutral and a basic analyte. And as we increase mass load on column, you can see that the basic peak shape really kind of turns like shark finny or really overloaded, where the neutral peak shape is very Gaussian and very commonly what you'd want to see for a peak.
Oh yeah, that's much better.
So this is something that's been known for a while. This is with small molecule, and I bet the same applies to basic peptides.
Okay.
So Kim, to probably test this myth, I think we need to look at a couple different stationary phases. Traditional, pure, modern stationary phases, and then one that may have a controlled surface charge on it.
What's a controlled surface charge?
Sure. So a controlled surface charge is where you take a pure stationary phase and you actually bond down to the surface, maybe a little bit of a positive surface charge, to actually add some repulsion for those basic analytes.
Ah, okay, interesting.
And we'll see if we can get improved peak shape for those basic analytes when using the low ionic strength acidic mobile phase, like formic acid.
Okay, let's do it.
All right, let's run it.
Okay, so once again, we put in a solid day of experimentation. What does it look like?
Sure, so we have some really unique results, which are actually pretty good and pretty interesting. We ran two columns. We ran a pure silica column, and we ran a column that had that charged surface put onto it. We ran the charged surface column with formic acid, and we ran the pure silica column with TFA, the ion pairing reagent. And as expected, that pure silica column for those basic peptides, you get very, very, very poor results. You get significant ion suppression, and you don't see any of the peptides really at all. But with the column that has the charged surface with the formic acid, boy, you really get great results. So again, you're running low ionic strength acidic mobile phase, and you're getting excellent TFA-like results.
That is exactly what our customer is looking for. Jonathan, based on the data that we saw then, it is possible for our scientists to get really good peak shape for basic compounds with a mass spec-friendly mobile phase like formic acid.
Exactly right, Kim. As long as you're using the appropriate column or stationary phase, one that has a controlled positive surface bonded to the surface, you'll get almost like ion pairing to the surface without the addition of an ion pairing reagent like TFA.
Right, so how do we call this one then?
It's almost like a plausible.
Yes, because it depends on the column that you're using, whether you can actually use a mass spec friendly mobile phase.
Exactly right.
All right, plausible. That works. Let's go ahead and type up our reply. If you'd like your question to be answered on a future episode, please feel free to email us at trustyourscience@waters.com.